Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Jessie and you're watching Reliable Roots, and today is an Earthschooling Preschool curriculum review. So what you're seeing right here are 3 months worth of the preschool curriculum available from earthschooling.com. I will leave links in the description box below. Now what you see right now is the printed out version. So this is not actually something that you can buy, because the Earthschooling curriculum is all available digitally. But that's a hard word, digitally. So what I like to do is I like to print out per season, because Waldorf curriculum focuses around the different seasons of the year. So with the kindergarten curriculum and the preschool curriculum, I print it out 3 months at a time. I have done this for summer now, and now I'm doing it for autumn. So I've not used the entire curriculum thus far. I've only used the summer curriculum, but as we are getting into autumn, I thought I'd go ahead and give you an overview of the preschool curriculum. This goes really hand in hand with the kindergarten curriculum, and I will post the link of the review that I did in the description box below as well, because they go really well hand in hand. Let's just go ahead and get into it. So what you see right now, this is an image I got offline and I just stuck it to the front. This is just a regular piece of cardstock that I printed out. It's blue because I didn't have any autumn colors, unfortunately. I really wanted like some orange or yellow or red, but all I had was like the light summer colors. So anyway, I printed this out on the blue cardstock and I laminated it, and then I took it down to have it bound, because I am a paper person. I don't do tablets, especially with like curriculum. I like things that I can write in and highlight, and I really like the binding so I can go like this and I can read and do that sort of thing. So preschool and kindergarten curriculums in Earthschooling are very, very similar. In fact, when I'm printing this out, I print out 1 month at a time, and each of the months are available for purchase. So you can do the entire year and save some money, or you can do 1 month at a time. But because they are available 1 month at a time, there is a lot of duplicate information. So I will show you what I mean. In the summer months, this is my summer curriculum. I did not have this laminated in the front, and I wish I would have, which is why I did that for autumn. But this is the summer that we just went through, and at the beginning of each month, I started on page 12, because each month is very, it has repeat information. At the beginning of each month, it has the same sort of thing for preschool and for kindergarten. So you will see that I did not print those things out. And what it is, it just kind of gives you an overview. In case you just wanted to purchase the month and not the entire year, you can do that, and it'll give you an overview of what the schedule is like and what each item means and represents. And so if you purchase the year and you print it out, there is a lot of duplicate information at the beginning of each month, which is why when I started to print this out, I start on page 12 or 13. So getting right into it, this is September. We're gonna start with September, and they have a snapshot of the month, and you have the daily themes, morning A, morning B, and that coincides with the schedule, which you will see right here. Each week has a different theme, and they all have this morning A, morning B, morning C, lunch, and then the afternoon. It all coincides with, this is all Waldorf inspired, so you have breathing out and breathing in and breathing out. The thing that I love about Waldorf education, not just about Earthschooling curriculum, but about Waldorf education in general, is that they focus on the mind, the body, and the spirit, which is why you have this breathing in and breathing out sort of thing. It is not per se a Christian curriculum or a Muslim curriculum or a Jewish curriculum, but it does have the aspects of the spirit, and you can incorporate whatever your beliefs are into the curriculum, which I just love. They also have, I will show you actually what I just did, in each of the months at the very beginning, the pages that I did not print out, they have daily reflections for 7 days out of the week. And so what I did is that I just wrote these out. This is the beeswax crayons that I just did like a little rainbow effect. And then using a marker, I put these on my wall. So each of these are the different reflections for week one, week two, and then you just alternate. So every single day of the week, during your circle time or whenever, is that you do these reflections about like intention and wishing and nourishing compassion, appreciating beauty, all these different things to go over with your children so that they can just reflect a little bit and be a little bit more mindful of their own spirit. Each day has the breathing out is circle time. That's pretty common. There's three verses and movement. So usually we will do like a little circle time. Sometimes if we get busy, if we have like field trips or something like that, we might do our verses in the car. I'm not sure if that's exactly per se Waldorf, or we might even do it on our nature walk, just depending on how busy our day does get. Each of the weeks has a different theme. And they also, what I also really love is that for snack times, they have different colors for each day of the week. So purple rice for Monday, red barley for Tuesday, and et cetera, et cetera. So they have the snack is always like a grain with a different type of color. You have oatmeal and golden raisins, wheatgrass, snow peas, apples, pears. I absolutely love this. This curriculum would be fabulous in an actual Waldorf school, and it is actually used in a whole lot of Waldorf schools, I think, because of this reason. It has all of this included, but it's also really great for homeschooling as well. So getting into September, we have different themes every single week. And also, this is also really great about the Earthschooling curriculum. Oh, there it is, the daily inner reflections. I didn't think that I printed that out, but it's the same thing that I just showed you that I wrote on the wall. Over here, we have the parent craft. So each month, there is a parent craft. So I have the preschool curriculum and the kindergarten curriculum. So there are two different parent crafts per curriculum. But the thing about this curriculum is that it goes so nicely with the kindergarten curriculum, and if you have children that are about the same ages, they just really coincide very nicely. So I get the option of doing one or the other, or I can do both, which a lot of times I do both because they are really great crafts and I really enjoy doing these crafts. My kids enjoy playing with them or watching me do them, and it also inspires them to do their own. For example, the Yarn Angel in the preschool curriculum is a parent craft for September. However, in the kindergarten curriculum, they will actually be making their own Yarn Angel in as part of their craft. So I really like that, how it does coincide so nicely with each other. And my preschooler can watch me make it, and then she can actually play with the Yarn Angel, and my kindergartner can actually make her own. So I really like that. Moving on. So a typical week in the Earthschooling curriculum looks very much like the kindergarten one. Like I said, they go hand in hand, very much so. You don't have to have the kindergarten curriculum with the preschool curriculum, but if you do have two children that are close in age like I do, this just works really, really well. They have the same theme. So this first week is bees and honey. So on the nature walk, it is a little bit different. They have different ideas for like the nature walk. This one in the preschool is you are a bee, and that's what you are going to be. That is your theme of the week with your nature walk, is that you are going to pretend to be a bee this week for your preschooler. However, for your kindergartner, it is the letter C in nature. So we are looking for the letter C. However, the theme of the week is still the same, bees and honey and bees and honey. So it's a lot of the similar things, but there are different verses. So it's not like a complete duplicate. The kindergarten curriculum is a lot thicker. And again, you can go look at that video if you want more information on the kindergarten curriculum that I've already done. So one big aspect of Waldorf education is you have the circle time with the verses, the snack, prepping and eating together. Eating is not just, you know, grab a quick snack and leave, which is something that I'm still trying to get into the habit of. It's like a whole spiritual thing, is that you are thanking God for where your food came from, even if it's just at snack time. So it's something that I'm still working with, trying to slow down enough to really appreciate every single meal and every single snack. But that is part of the Waldorf education, and I really like how Earthschooling emphasizes this. Also, lots of free play, lots of rest time, or free play and rest time. And they also have the story time. Now, story time is in Waldorf education. You read the story by yourself, take 3 minutes to read the story, and then you retell it. So you're not reading the story straight from the book, or you're not supposed to. The idea is not that you're reading it straight from the curriculum, but that you are actually reading it and then saying it back to the students. And it takes 3 days to say this story. And when I say that, it doesn't actually take 3 days. You're gonna say the story on day one, On day two, you will tell the story and you will have them participate in some way. And then day three, you will tell the story with participation again. So what I like to do with this is that I'll tell the story on day one. On day two, that we will tell the story again, just to reiterate that story. And on day three, I usually have them tell me the story back. Sometimes we will use fairies. If there's fairies in the story, we might even do a drawing of it. However you want to do that with the participation. There is also, in the preschool, you have finger rhymes on Thursday, that there's always some sort of finger rhyme movement. And that kind of differs a little bit from the kindergarten curriculum because they usually have like a game instead of the finger rhymes, but my kindergartner likes to do it with the preschooler as well. Now, along with the 3 days of story time, you also have one craft that will take 3 days, and that's the same thing in the kindergarten curriculum. For this one, it's a bee rattle, so you do it on day one, day two, day three. And for the actual craft itself, it will usually take you through what that actually looks like. That they don't do it for this one, but they will actually take you through 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, depending on the type of craft it is. They will tell you what you need to do on day one, on day two, and on day three. So like this one, it doesn't take you through the 3 days, so you can kind of figure out, pace yourself. You can do it all in 1 day if you want to. You can make several of them throughout the course of 3 days, but that 3 day is an important part of Waldorf education because it really solidifies the lesson that you are teaching. And then finally, finishing up the week, this is the same as the kindergarten, you have a watercolor story for the week. So I like this because you have one story that lasts for 3 days, then you have the finger rhyme, and then you have the watercolor story. So you're actually getting 3 stories for the week, and they are interactive and they are very hands-on, and it's great to develop that fantasy and imagination. Now, one thing that I've been reading up about with the Waldorf curriculum is the importance of delayed academics. And that's something, because I now have a 6-year-old who is still in the kindergarten curriculum, and why that is so important when it comes to all this fantasy and all the stories and stuff, especially at the preschool and kindergarten level, is because when you think about it, whenever you read a story, you have to have imagination. You have to be able to see that story through your head. And that is why Waldorf, that is one of the reasons why Waldorf focuses so much on creating that imagination, because then if the children can actually picture and visualize it in their head, then that makes reading and comprehension a lot easier down the road. So I love that. Now, that is a typical week. Now, the great thing about the Earthschooling curriculum, first of all, it is significantly cheaper than other Waldorf-inspired curriculums that I have seen. In fact, I believe it is the most affordable that I have seen online if you are buying new. Now, if you buy secondhand, you might be able to get something secondhand, but for buying new, it is fabulous. This is all you see is my printed out with this review. However, if you actually purchase the Earthschooling curriculum, you get MP3s, you get videos, you get all sorts of teacher resources with that. And you also get to participate in all these groups that have great project ideas, and they also share very frequently about what they are doing and how they are doing it as well. Also, the Earthschooling curriculum has a Q&A with a certified Waldorf teacher once a week. Oh, and they also have, I love the MP3s that are available online, because it does some of these verses that are done at the beginning of each week, because each week you will be learning at least 1 to 2 new verses like these. They are all available online, okay? So you can actually listen to those and learn those before you actually teach them to your preschooler. So just to reiterate what a typical week looks like, first of all, there are 52 weeks, I believe, available of the Earthschooling curriculum. I haven't gone through the entire year yet, but they do have every single month is available for the entire year. So if you want to do summer school, if you want to do year-round schooling, that is all available. It's not broken into just 36 weeks. I believe that there's a full 52 weeks available. So I like to print mine out 3 months at a time. I like to print mine out 3 months at a time. I have not looked at the entire year because that's overwhelming to me. Okay, so that about wraps up this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to give it a thumbs up and leave me a comment below if you have any questions about the Waldorf curriculum or the Waldorf inspired curriculum or the Earthschooling curriculum in general. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you later. Bye.